A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 2nd November, on the front page you have Jharkhand polls to be held in 5 phases, results on December 23. So the first phase of elections will be held on November 30 and the last on December 20. So Election Commission of India has announced the dates for the polls in Jharkhand. The Chief Election Commissioner, you should know, is Sunil Arora. Also, postal ballots have been announced for elderly, persons with disabilities and senior citizens, both. Then, this is WhatsApp did not inform government of system breach. So, it is legally bound to do so under the Information Technology Act is what the officials have said, that WhatsApp failed to inform the government of a breach of its system through an Israeli spyware. So, this is what the government is trying to say, that WhatsApp had the responsibility to inform the government. While WhatsApp's allegation is that government authorities are suspected to have used this spyware through WhatsApp, you know, to spy on activists, Dalit leaders and lawyers, human rights activists from India. And it's not just a case in India, it has made international news from around the world. So spyware has been used. Then below you have auto white goods sales up in October. So the festive season has brought cheer for automobile and white goods sector. So you should know what are white goods. This terminology is important. So you can see white goods are goods are actually electronic goods of household use, which are generally white in color. So that's the terminology which is used, like for washing machine, fridge, etc. Then here you have Jammu and Kashmir situation is not sustainable, is what German Chancellor Angela Merkel has said to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. She's on a visit to India. So she says that she has expressed concern for the people of Kashmir and said that the lockdown of the region cannot be supported for long. Then health emergency declared in the capital. So hospitals report rise in respiratory and eye problems as air quality has entered severe plus category in Delhi. And below you have TRAI fixes ring timings for mobile landlines and rule will apply across operators. So now mobile phone users will get 30 seconds to answer or reject a call before it is considered a missed call. So this is a new regulation TRAI has fixed. The ring time for calls made to mobiles should be 30 seconds and those to landlines as 60 seconds. So this notification is likely to impact the interconnect usage charges between operators. So presently you can see rules which are there. Reliance Jio and Bharti Airtel are also, you know, fighting on this issue. So Bharti Airtel has cut the ringing time for calls made by its subscribers to 25 seconds from earlier 45 seconds. So this is retaliation to a similar move by Jio, Reliance Jio. This has resulted in TRAI intervening in the matter. So interconnection usage charges have to be paid. Like if a call comes from Airtel on Reliance Jio number, then Airtel has to pay this interconnect usage charges. So if it's a missed call, and you know, you can see it's less than 30 seconds as such, then it would not result in interconnect usage charges to be paid. So that is the issue. But TRAI will now bring out rules which will make it, you know, fix a time of how long it would be that a user would get to answer or reject a call. Then this is 6 found guilty in 2008 Rampur terror attack case. So these are 8 accused, out of which 2 have been acquitted, and the court will announce the quantum of punishment for them too. So this is 2008 Rampur terror attack case, which took place on a CRPF camp in UP, in which 7 jawans were killed and a rickshaw puller also lost his life. On page 9 you have burning of stubble down 40%, Supreme Court told. So Supreme Court has been informed by Union Minister of Environment and Forest that incidents of stubble burning in the 3 states neighboring Delhi, that is Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh have come down by 41% since 2016. So this is the center's claim in the Supreme Court. Affidavit has been filed, while on the front page we saw how Delhi is in severe plus category of pollution. And this is women to be inducted in army by end 2021. So over 100 have been shortlisted for military police, and they would be inducted in for the corps of military police in this as such. On the editorial page you have the first editorial, from bad to worse. So this is regarding the core sector output. We saw the news yesterday on front page about how core sector has contracted. So it's a sharp 5.2% contraction in September 2019, which has been seen. So all seven out of the eight core sectors, seven have been in the negative, and only fertilizer saw growth, positive growth. So this contraction indicates that economic slowdown, recovery from this is still far away. And this is cramped prisons. So it says jails in India remain crowded as few states have implemented reforms for decongestion. So decongesting jails have to be undertaken, but that has not been picked up seriously. Rajasthan and Maharashtra have not managed to augment jail capacity to fit in the increased inmate population. Then the lead article is the perils of post-370 diplomacy. So the internationalization of Kashmir issue points to troubling divergence from India's traditional foreign policy. So this is a point being made that when members of European Parliament have been called to visit Jammu and Kashmir, it is internationalization of the issue. So this is troubling divergence from India's traditional foreign policy. And this is in WhatsApp breach, follow the money trail. So when the question arises, who in India can afford to use expensive Pegasus spyware and target select individuals, money trail has to be looked at. Then on Saturdays on op-ed page, you have ground zero coverage. So this is regarding excavations in the tiny hamlet of Keeladi, which prove that an urban civilization existed in Tamil Nadu in the Sangam era on the banks of river Vaigai. So what links do this civilization had with Indus Valley civilization is an interesting question on which answers have been thrown up. So this is the civilization shown here. Right. So this is the graffiti which has been found, you can see, in Keeladi. It is compared with signs of Indus Valley, of how similar they are. So the graffiti marks encountered in Iron Age sites of South India serve as only residual links between Indus Valley civilization and South India. Then on page 12 you have Home Ministry retains final say on AFSPA in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So this is Armed Forces Special Powers Act. So it has been in force in these areas since 1990, and now Cabinet Secretariat has issued notified rules reasserting Union Home Ministry as the authority that would decide on imposition of AFSPA in Union Territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So you should know about this act, the controversial act. It empowers security forces to conduct operations anywhere and arrest anyone without a warrant. It has been in force in Jammu and Kashmir since 1990. It has been in force in other regions also, like in northeastern states too. This is regarding AFSPA. The Supreme Court has also blunted the act, because the act also had provision that anything done under this act cannot be questioned in the court of law. But Supreme Court has stated that if it is any undue, you know, force being used, because it also gives right to kill, but if undue force is used as such, then the case would go before the Supreme Court. Then on page 13 you have joblessness rises to 3-year high. So India's unemployment rate in October 2019 rose to 8.5%, the highest level since August 2016. So this is data released by Center for Monitoring Indian Economy. Here the details are also provided about how agricultural sector fall is being seen, services has been rising, manufacturing has seen a dip. So, yeah. And this is over the years, you can see. rural, urban and total. So highest unemployment has been seen since 2016. Then this is India, Germany need to fight terror. So in the context of German Chancellor Angela Merkel's visit to India, this statement has been made that by President Ramnath Kovind that terror safe havens must be eliminated in every part of the world. Then this is electoral bonds worth 232 crore rupees were sold in October 2019. So from March 2018 to October 2019, 12,313 electoral bonds have been sold. So this is the data shared by Association for Democratic Reform. So Mumbai has the highest amount of bonds which have been sold. So you should know these are electoral bonds through which donations are given to political parties now. That's the idea. There is no limit on how much donation can be given, and it is exempted. Political parties are exempted from any kind of taxes. So they can get as much amount of donation as they want. It would not be taxed. Then this is India caucus co-chair's statement to US congressional record supports Modi. So a little over a week after India was scrutinized at US House of Representatives hearing on human rights in South Asia, the co-chair of the congressional caucus on India and Indian Americans submitted a statement to the congressional record in support of Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Parliament for the recent action in Jammu and Kashmir. On international page you have protesters want Imran Khan to resign. So this is tens of thousands of protesters led by Jamaat-e-Ulema-Islami leader Maulana Fazlur Rahman. They took out a march in Islamabad demanding resignation of Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan. So it is alleged that in 2018 elections, army played a role in making Imran Khan win. So now they are demanding he resign in 2 days. And this is US agency grounds Chinese drones. So Department of Interior of USA has decided to ground Chinese drones amid concerns that these drones, unmanned aerial vehicles, pose security risk. These are Chinese made drones. And below you have Beijing can slap tariffs of $3.6 billion on US goods. So anti-dumping duties have caused loss to China. So World Trade Organization arbitrator on Friday authorized China to slap tariffs on US imports worth up to $3.58 billion annually in a years-long dispute over US anti-dumping practices. So China had asked WTO for permission to hit US with more than $7 billion in tariffs in the case. But WTO ruling came on 3.58. So WTO ruling said it had determined that the illegal US anti-dumping practices had caused nullification or impairment of benefits accruing to China. Then on business page you have festive season brings cheer for auto consumer durables. So automakers see higher month-on-month sales in October aided by discounts, and even consumer durables like washing machine, refrigerators and TVs have seen rise in sales. You should know this is continuation of the front page news. So what we spoke of was automobiles and white goods. So white goods are these consumer durables. You should know the terminologies too, like washing machine, refrigerators, TVs. These are called white goods. Then the last page has no news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.